The question is a mixture of KCl and KClO3. So we have a mixture of KCl and KClO3 weighing 1.8 grams. So this mixture's weight is 1.8 gram. Okay. And we have heated this mixture. After the reaction, the dry oxygen gas generated occupied 140 ml at STP. So when we have heated up this reaction, we get basically dry oxygen, okay, and the volume of this dry oxygen is 140 ml at standard temperature pressure, okay. Next is, what percentage of original mixture was KClO3? So we have to figure out the percentage of KClO3 in the mixture, okay. So whatever mixture we have taken, what percentage of KClO3 is present in the mixture? That is what we need to figure out in the question. Now this is the idea, this is the basic framework of the question, okay. We have to figure out KClO3. The best way of dealing with such type of question is to go with the inverse method, okay. We have to figure out KClO3, but what we have in our hands, oxygen, okay. So we'll be using the oxygen, and then we'll take whatever information we can take from the oxygen, then we can just go to KClO3. That's the inverse method we would be using in the question. So if we would heat KCl and KClO3 mixture, we would get oxygen from KClO3, right? KCl does not give oxygen, KClO3 would be giving the oxygen. So we would be heating KClO3, and KClO3 will basically produce oxygen. So let's say we have KClO3. That means it has nothing to do, oxygen information has nothing to do with KCl, okay. It has only relationship with KClO3. So KClO3, when heated, will give you KCl, that is potassium chloride plus oxygen, okay. That's how we're going to solve the question. So let's balance this equation. So we have basically, let's take twice of KClO3, that would be twice of KCl. We have six molecules of, we have six atoms of your oxygen, so we would be balancing this equation with 3 moles of oxygen, okay. So this is the balanced equation. That's how we are going to balance this equation. Now what we have in the reaction vessel, we have 140 ml of oxygen gas, okay. We know we can figure out number of moles of oxygen with the help of this volume at standard temperature pressure, okay. So first, what we would be doing, we would be finding out the number of moles of O2 liberated, okay. This is what we would be doing in our first step. That is, given volume 140 ml and given volume at STP is 22400 ml, right? I know you all are clear with this concept, okay. We have calculators in TIA for examination, so you can solve this calculation with help of calculator. So 140 divided by 22400, so this would give you 0.00625 moles of O2 gas, right? This is the first information that we got from the question, okay. Now the next thing is, we know that 2 moles of oxygen, okay, or we can say 3 moles of O2 requires 2 moles of KClO3, right, okay. So 1 mole of O2 require 2 by 3 moles of KClO3. Am I clear on this point? Okay. What we basically need to find out, we need to find out the number of moles of KClO3 that we had, right, which will give you 140 ml of oxygen gas. So 1 mole of oxygen require 2 by 3 moles of KClO3. What we have this moles of oxygen, okay, 0.0625 moles of oxygen. Therefore, 0.00625 moles of oxygen will require how much? 2 by 3 into 0.00625 moles of your KClO3, moles of KClO3. Okay, you can figure out this answer, 0.00625 into 2 by 3. So basically that will give you how much? 0.00416 moles of KClO3. So this information basically we got from the calculation that we would be having this much moles of KClO3 in the given reaction mixture. Okay, so let's note down this relevant information over here. So the information is, first is we have how much? 0.00416 moles of KClO3 in reaction mixture. Alright, let's rub off this information or this calculations. What next we have to do? Now we got number of moles in the reaction mixture of KClO3. I'm sure now you can figure out the given weight of KClO3 from number of moles formula. Okay, that's not a difficult thing to do. So we have given moles, now we can figure out the given weight as well. Okay, so what's the number of moles equation? First is number of mole is equals to given weight by molar mass. Okay, we have number of moles of KClO3. We can calculate molecular weight of KClO3 as well. Okay, from these two things we can actually get given weight of KClO3 in the reaction vessel. Okay, let's do that. Number of moles is 0.00416 and molecular weight would be what we can take of potassium. What is the molecular weight of potassium? That is 31. Okay, roughly it's 31. Then we have chlorine, 35.5. then we have 3 times of oxygen, that is 16. Okay, that's how we can solve this particular question. Okay, you have calculators in the examination. I'm sure you can do the calculation in the examination. If in case you're not, you know, you don't have the value of KClO3, definitely we cannot remember all these right values, so we can actually solve this particular thing in examination hall. Okay, so how we can actually solve it? Okay, I'm sorry, it's 39, right? It's 39.09. yeah, this is the molecular weight of your, this is the molar mass of basically your potassium. Okay, so this is molar mass of potassium, that is 39, and then we have 35.5 from chlorine, and then we have 16 from oxygen. Okay, you can actually calculate it. So this is 39 plus 35.5 plus we have 3 times of 16, that is 122.5. okay, now we can solve this particular question. So 122.5 into 0.00416, this will give you 0.5096 as molecular weight of KClO3. Is this point clear to all of you? Okay, so this is the second information that we got from the calculation, that given weight of KClO3 in mixture is actually 0.5096. okay, I hope this point is also clear to all of you. Now we are very very close to our answer. Okay, what we have to figure out? We have to figure out percentage of KClO3 in original mixture. Okay, so next step we have to do is we have 1.8 grams of KCl and KClO3. Now we know that 0.5096 weight is coming from KClO3. okay, so we have to figure out the percentage of KClO3. So we have 0.5096 of KClO3 divided by total weight of your mixture, that is 1.8. okay, just divide it by 1.8 and multiply this with 100, that will give you weight percentage of your KClO3 which was asked in the question. Okay, so this would be roughly around, let's do the calculation. Yeah, so this would be roughly around 28.31. okay, and in the question it's 28.4, so approximately it would be 28.4. okay, so the correct answer for the question is option A. okay, that's how you can solve the question. Very simple. Okay, just take the reverse method and you can actually solve the question. I hope this question is clear to all of you.